Dear students, in the previous session we have discussed the equation of a plane passing through three non-collinear points and also the problems. So in this session I am going to discuss the equation of a plane in intercept form. So students, let us consider the intercept form of a plane here. So first consider three dimensional space. So which are three coordinate axes x, y, z. Let the plane cut x, y and z axis at the points A, B, C respectively. So these are the points A, B, C on x, y, z axis respectively. So this is the plane which cuts that all the three coordinates at the points A, B, C respectively. So x intercept, that can be taken as small a. So this is the length a at which the point that plane cuts here, right? So that the coordinates of the point a are taken as a comma 0 comma 0. Next, y intercept, that can be taken as small b. So this implies that point B has the coordinates 0 comma B comma 0. Similarly, that Z intercept can be taken as small c. That implies the coordinates of the point C are 0 comma 0 comma C. Now here consider all the three points and that intercepts and points here. Let the equation of the plane be ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0. Consider this is as equation number 1, where capital D should not be equal to 0. Here a, b, c are constants here, right? So these are the points on the coordinate axis. Since a lies on the plane, then we get mean that point satisfy this equation of the plane. So now here we can replace the values of x, y, z by using a 0 0, so that this equation becomes capital A into small a plus capital D is equal to 0. Because if you put y, z as 0 0, then these two terms are vanished here. Therefore, the remaining part is capital A into A plus D is equal to 0. So that A into small a is equal to minus D, and capital A is equal to minus D divided by small a. Similarly, we can consider that second point B lies on the plane. So that we get from the equation number 1, so that x, z coordinates are 0 here. So the remaining part is capital B into small b plus capital D is equal to 0. Therefore, capital B into small b is equal to minus D. Then capital B is equal to small d divided by minus D divided by small b. Therefore, these two are the values of capital A and capital B. Similarly, consider that third point C also lies on the plane. Therefore, we get from the equation number 1, that is capital C into small c, because x and y coordinates are 0 here. So remaining part is here, that is capital C into small c plus D is equal to 0. Then this implies capital C into small c is equal to small d. After transferring this d to the RHS side, then capital C becomes, that is, minus capital D divided by small c. So now substitute the values of a, b, c in the equation number 1, that is ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0. Therefore, we get, that is, minus d by small a into x plus minus d by small b into y plus minus d divided by c into z plus capital D is equal to 0. So students, in this equation, minus d is common in these four terms, so that we can divide this whole equation by minus capital D. Therefore, we get x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1, because here if you get minus 1, so after transferring RHS side, so it becomes plus 1. Therefore, x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1 is the intercept form of equation of plane. So remember the student, this is only the standard equation, that intercept form of plane. Now we will solve some of the examples on this intercept form. Let us consider the question number 1. Find the equation of the plane with intercepts 2, 3, 4 with x, y and z axis respectively. For the solution, we consider the intercepts. So this is x intercept, this is y intercept, and it is z intercept. Therefore, x intercept is equal to small a, so that is 2. Y intercept is equal to small b, is equal to 3, and z intercept, that is small c, is equal to 4. Now consider the equation of the plane in intercept form. So that is x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1. Now to find out the equation of the plane, replace the values of a, b, c here. So these are the a, b, c values. Now we can take in the next step x by a. A means what is that here? This value is 2. So that it becomes x by 2 plus y by 3 plus z by 4 is equal to 1. Now we have to take the LCM of denominators here. So denominators are 2, 3, 4. Then LCM of 2, 3, 4 is 12. Therefore, we have to multiply here, that is 6, because the denominator is 2. We have to multiply 6 here. So it becomes 6x, and denominator is 3, but the LCM is 12, means we have to multiply by 4 to this y. So it becomes plus 4y, and the denominator is 4, so we have to multiply 3 here. So it becomes plus 3z divided by 12 is equal to 1. Now transfer this 12 to this RHS side, so it becomes multiplied. So this implies 6x plus 4y plus 3z is equal to 12. So which is only the required equation of the plane with intercepts 2, 3, 4 with x, y and z axis respectively. Similarly, go for the next example, question number 2. A plane passes through the points 3, 0, 0, 0, 5, 0, 0, 0, 2. Now find the equation. Now let us take the plane, cut x, y and z axis at A, B, C respectively. Right. Therefore, this is the plane. So that cuts axis A, B, C at A, B, C respectively. Three planes. So the plane passes through the point A. Therefore, which has the coordinate 3, 0, 0, this implies x intercept, that is small a, so this is equal to what here? 3 now, right? Similarly, B point has the coordinate 0, 5, 0. Therefore, from this point, we can say that the y intercept becomes, that is B is equal to 5. Also, we can take the third point, the coordinates are 0, 0, 2. So, this implies z intercept is equal to small c. So, that is equal to 2. Right. Now, we can find out the equation by using the intercept form of a plane. That is x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1. Now replace the values of a, b, c here. So it becomes x by 3 plus y by 5 plus z by 2 is equal to 1. Now consider the denominator 3, pi, 2. So the LCM of 3, pi, 2 is 30. Therefore, we can simplify this one by adding. So here denominator is 3, so we have to multiply by 10 here, so it becomes 10x, and denominator is 5 here, so we have to multiply by 6, because the already I have told you the LCM is 30, so that we have to multiply by 6 here, so it becomes plus 6y plus, so denominator is 2 here, so we have to multiply by 15, so this is plus 15z divided by 30 is equal to 1. Now here transfer this 30 to the RHS side, so it becomes 10x plus 6y plus 15z is equal to 30. So this is only the required equation of the plane in intercept form. So question number 3, find the intercepts cut off by the plane 2x plus y minus z is equal to 5. So for the solution, now here remember the equation of the plane in intercept form is x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1. Now consider the given equation of the plane b 2x plus y minus z is equal to 5. So to find out the intercepts cut off by the plane, so we have to convert into the standard form of the plane in intercept form. So that is x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1, so that RHS part should be equal to 1. So for that I have to divide this whole equation by 5. Therefore, divide by 5, here we get 2 by 5 x plus 1 by 5 into y minus 1 by 5 into z is equal to 1, because 5 by 5 is equal to 1. Now we have to convert into standard form, means the coefficient of the x should be 1, means the denominator should be in the form of a, and the coefficient of y should be also plus 1, the denominator is in the form of b, and z coefficient is also should be plus 1, so denominator should be in the form of c here, so that we have to take this one to the denominator side, so it becomes x divided by 5 by 2 after transferring denominator side. So similarly it becomes y divided by 5, and this one z divided by minus 5, z divided by minus 5, because we have to take to the denominator side, so it becomes minus 5, so it is whole equal to 1. Now see here, after comparing the equation of the plane in the intercept form, and already we got this equation here, so comparing here we get the value of a here, so that x intercept is what here, that is 5 by 2 small a, so it is small a, so that it is 5 by 2, and y intercept, so that is small b is equal to 5 here, and also z intercept, that is small c, is equal to minus 5. So these are the intercepts cut off by the given plane. So this is how to find out the intercepts. Similarly, we will solve one more example. The question number 4, find the intercepts made by the plane 2x minus 3y plus 5z plus 4 is equal to 0 on the coordinate axis. So similar type of procedure from the previous example. Again, just imagine the equation of the plane in the intercept form is x by a plus y by b plus z by c is equal to 1. So if you convert this equation into the standard form, then we get the intercepts a, b, c here. So now we rearrange this equation, means we have to transfer this 4 to the rth side, so it becomes minus 4. Therefore, after rearranging, we have 2x minus 3y plus 5z is equal to minus 4. Okay, students, already I have told you that RHS part should be equal to 1. Therefore, we have to divide this whole equation by minus 4, right? Therefore, divide by minus 4, we will be having minus 1 by 2x. Similarly, plus 3 by 4y minus 1 by 4 means it becomes minus 5 by 4 z is equal to 1, because here we have to divide by minus 4, so it becomes 1. Now already I have told you to convert into the standard form, so that a should be in the denominator side, so that we have to take the whole term to the denominator side. So we have x divided by minus 2, because if you take to the denominator side, it becomes here reverse, so that it becomes 2 by 1, therefore it becomes x divided by minus 2, because the coefficients of x, y, z should be positive, therefore we have to take minus 2 the denominator side. Next, plus y divided by 4 by 3, similarly plus z divided by minus 4 by 5. Is equal to 1. Students, now compare the standard form and also the equation here. The value of a is minus 2, therefore x intercept is small a is equal to minus 2, and y intercept is small b, that is 4 by 3, and therefore here that intercept is small c, that is equal to minus 4 by 5. So this is the solution how to find out the intercepts made by the given plane on the coordinate axis. Students, I have completed this session now. So from this session and also from the previous sessions, here I have given assignment number 7 here. So these are the questions you have to solve based on the session, today's session and also the previous session. So solve these all the examples. So in the next class, we will discuss some more points here. So after that, here just practice well all these concepts and also the problems. Thank you, students.